Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nicher, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. And here I'm going to stress that these dog-collared people that are employees of the Mammon, and they pretend or tell people that the working for God is a nonsense. And they are the crook who are not telling the truth. Remember that what is in your heart, and if you say something different from your mouth, then you commit blasphemy. And blasphemy is a transgression against the crime against the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, whatever you do against it, is not forgivable. Sin is forgivable because sins are transgression against the moral laws made by men, so men can forgive it. But these blasphemy, which is against the Holy Spirit, only because Holy Spirit belongs to God, and only God can forgive you, and that too if you are sincerely repentful, if you have done something wrong without knowledge. But if you have done something wrong knowingly, then of course you bear the consequences. So these priests in the churches, in their heart they know that they are just like secular employees. They are working for Mammon and getting fat salaries and living a very comfortable life, as it was during the time when Christ Jesus came into this world. So when he came into this world, he found in the temple the priests were living lavishly, putting on silken clothes and all that embroidered tunics and many other things, whereas our anointed elder brother, the royal priest, our royal high priest, he was just in a simple clothing. No special clothing, just ordinary. Because in Christ Jesus, what comes out of your mouth, that matters. And not these gowns or robes, which are only to cheat the simple-minded people, which we call stones. That's why Jesus said, turning stone into bread. So these crooks in churches, they turn these stones into bread, as they were doing at the time of Christ Jesus, when a widow put her mite into their treasury. Remember, our anointed elder brother Christ Jesus pointed out how those temple priests were living lavishly in silken clothing on the devotion of poor people, highlighted by Christ Jesus in the widow's mite instance. Today these hireling dog-collar or robed priests are worse than those, for they have no knowledge of gospel, but they groom the simple-minded stone-headed people. Stone-headed mean that they cannot think. That's why Simon was called a Peter stone, because he was once born, but he was clean-hearted. Stone-headed people feeding them with most sugar-coated sermons to attract more people into their nets or into their churches, the false churches which are of the Mammon dominated. You see them in churches having big fat accounts. Same is in the Sikh temples, same in Hindu temples, same in mosques. All these people who are there, because this is the age of Christ in which Everyone has to give his own account to God. They cannot give your account to God, but they are just a parasite on the churches. And they create fog of falsehood. Falsehood, which is sugar-coated sermon they deliver. They are incapable of speaking the gospel truth, because simple truth even hurts. Peter, when he established the church, he did not allow any liars into the church. He killed two, Sapphira and Ananias, for telling lies. When you don't allow any liar into a church, then your church is built on a solid rock, which water can come, it will not move. And when you have a sound foundation, then only you can start building the house of God on top of it. But if your foundation is on sand, sand means liars, cheat, as these clerics themselves are, then your house cannot stand water. The test of water means the people are liars or not liars. So water is concerned with sins, and what comes out of your mouth is concerned with blasphemy or of God. So these people, they create blindness in churches. More popularity of the church, more money for the priests, who happily enjoy feeding upon the widow's mite. This is very much true in the poor countries such as Romania that I visited, Russia, and all these East European countries, where people are hard up, like that widow. You know, in these countries, in Romania and other places, there are many poor people. Their average income is very low. I hear the doctor over there, after spending 5-6 years in the college or university, he only gets 800 RON per month, which is around £200 a month. Whereas a doctor in England gets £200 in a day. So you can see how poor those people are, and they are then open to bribery also, because they can't keep up their standard. So they will ask the patient to give bribe, or the patient themselves will give them bribe, so that they can be treated quick and efficiently. So such is the poverty, and these over there, these Catholic fathers, Orthodox and whatnot, the color they have, they put on very expensive gowns, and they are provided by their churches to prove that, oh, their priest is well more better dressed than the other. So those stupid people are the stones. They provide the priest with the expensive gowns, tunic, and then he will charge them for saying prayer. If you want a prayer to be asked, the priest to say prayer for them, he will ask you how much money you are going to give me. Sometimes they put a fixed rate, this much for this prayer, and this for such a long prayer. So such malpractices are going on there. And the priests are no more, they are godly, but of a mammon. So it's our duty, those who are twice born, they are very few, to alert people, to open their eyes, and ask them to think logically. And if the man you are having in the church is a mammon worshipper, how can he lead you to God.